Hello folks, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. So we're going to be taking a look at Zenkit To-Do. This is a new application, a little bit of a spin-off of the popular project management software from Zenkit. And it is essentially looking to replace Wunderlist on May the 6th when that shuts down. Now we're going to register, we're going to sign up for an account and do a little bit of a tour of what it looks like and how to go about using it. So let's get started. Know about the registry is you can actually log in or sign up using Google, Apple, Microsoft, Facebook, and Trello, which is a pretty decent lineup in case you wanted to use another piece of software. Okay, so once we're all signed in, as you can see when you enter the application, this is the web version. So there is also going to be an Android and iOS version launching today. So it looks pretty much identical to what Wunderlist looked like previously. You have this sort of like central column with this left-hand sidebar, which can be minimized if you did want to. But essentially down this left-hand side, you can start adding projects or lists. And then on this right-hand side, you can activate all of the task details once you've added certain tasks. So let's start adding a few projects. So if you wanted to, when you go and create your list, you can actually import from two other applications. That's Wunderlist naturally and also Asana. So it will import whatever projects you have inside of those applications. Now, if I wanted to go ahead and start adding some house errands, I could start adding some tasks up in the center here. Okay, so once I've added a few tasks, very similar to Wunderlist, if you click into a task, on this right-hand side, you'll be able to see a bit of the task details. And you can see that obviously Microsoft To-Do was also inspired by this design. So you can also add a due date to them. So for example, the due date here to actually clear the workspace, you can add a reminder. If it's a repeater task, say I wanted to do this every single week on a Wednesday, I could go ahead and create that, and you can see it's weekly on a Tuesday and Wednesday there. I can add subtasks, add any notes here, and as you can see, the notes appear as an option. You can have that as a floating one here, so if I press Control, you can add that as a floating area here, allowing you to add it in HTML, Markdown, or even just plain text. Over here, you can also add attachments and add comments as well. Now up here, if you've got any sort of task, you can archive and delete it, but you can even show it as a pop-up, so it'll appear in the center of the screen. You can also change that setting to appear as a side panel if you want to for future tasks. You can even move this to the list, copy it to another list, and share a link directly. Now, as you can see on this left-hand side, new areas start beginning to appear, so you can see that this is the week ahead. And you can start to see some of the tasks there. You can also see an inbox, and this is useful for if you're clipping stuff throughout the day. So just to pause there is some form of pricing plan to this one. The Zenkit To-Do has four pricing plans. The personal one that I'm on right now gives you access to up to 8 free members, 500 megabytes, 80 lists, which is fairly reasonable, and 2,400 tasks, 20 folders, two-step, and also reminders, comments, and file uploads, which I guess is slightly better to some extent than the Todoist setup, but it's dependent on what feature you highlight. You've also got a plus plan, which is $4 per user per month, and that is not the annual fee. That gets you up to 100 paid members being able to use it, 6 gigabytes attachment space, 800 lists, 80,000 tasks, 200 folders, and a few more accessibilities, including coming soon, email to list and iCloud calendar subscription. And there is also a business plan, which is $19 per user per month, which is a bit more enterprise focused, as well as an enterprise plan, which is pretty much unlimited with custom abilities. Now inside the settings, there's not really much to talk about. You can see here that you can upgrade from here and it will give you the pricing plans and details. The annual plan for Zenkit To-Do is $36, which is not too bad. And that's part of the plus plan. So that's if you wanted to upgrade. And that's pretty much like a comparable application probably to TickTick and Todoist, as they're really the sort of experiences that are, you know, being compared to this. Although they don't, you know, they do have smart lists. I'll probably be digging a little deeper into this application in a formalized review. They also have themes, and the reason why many people are saying this is exactly a comparison to the likes of Wunderlist is the themes are pretty much the same. You can see this pretty much awesomely designed alternative to that Wunderlist background, but it looks pretty cool, and you can even get your own one in the plus plan. If you got the plus plan, you can upload your own image. Now you also have the ability to modify your notifications and also create these smart lists, and the smart lists are very similar to what you would see inside of TickTick. And what you can do is have them set up, so for example you want to start automatically rolling on them, you can begin to add them there. So if I go back, you can see here, if I go to all, that will show all of my current tasks during the day. And I can even do the same with the today area, and I can start adding my tasks here. So folks, as I'm editing this now, I actually thought that I missed out on a couple of things that might be handy for those who are looking to actually jump in with this application. And the first is folders. So obviously you can go ahead and create folders inside of your workspaces, and you can do that by right-clicking on the list you've created. And there's an option here called Move to New Folder. So you can modify each of the folders a lot more. You can add a description, you can add a icon color, but do note that I believe some of these are limited inside of the Plus plan. So obviously you can choose a color, and you can choose a background for the icon. But if you wanted to go for, say, an icon of home in this case, in which you can find in the search, that's going to be a paid feature. So that's something to note. You can also export that whole list as a CSV, and you can write and choose the access here. So you can even go down here and add a new member if you wish. So in this case, I can actually move this to a new folder. In this case, I might call the whole area personal, and it breaks out into a new section. And naturally, that has its own setting abilities for you to access the invites available to it. And you can access, you can invite up to 8 people in the free plan too. And down at the bottom here, you can transfer the ownership over to another person if, for example, a project details has changed. So in the free plan, you get up to 20 folder access or folder creation. And the way you can quickly check that is go to Settings, Upgrade. And I only found this a minute ago, and press Show Product Usage. And you can see here that these are all the folders I'm actively using, and I've used 2 out of 20. And I actually quite like this because some applications only tell you when you've gone ahead and created one more, and then it tells you and you're like, oh, I have to go ahead and delete loads or change to my structure. And that's quite helpful. Now in terms of tasks, so we created a task here a minute ago, clean workspace. You can add a subtask. And so for example, I may say get wipes from downstairs could be one of those tasks in breaking it down. And I could say wipe PC, wipe, and I could say wipe or clean keyboard. And you can see there that I have 3 subtasks here. And naturally what I can do is if I say complete a task, the one thing that you'll notice is that the completion appears on this bar, which I really like. This is such a subtle feature, and it actually happens inside of TickTick, but not as visually appealing as this. And say I went to complete the whole thing. You can see here that the whole thing is pretty much done. And when I tick off a task, you heard a completion sound, which was quite nice. So you can add up to 2,400 tasks to an account. And those tasks are deemed to be those that are active. So if I go over to here, and you can see here that I only have 3 tasks that are active inside of my entire account. So the other thing you can do is add a file to anything. So for example, if I've just added a attachment, I can add it through the likes of Dropbox, Google Drive, Box, and even an external link. Let's say I just wanted to add this one upload quickly. There is a limit of 20 megabytes per file to be added to a task. And there's also a limit total on the free account to 500 megabyte attachment space, although there is actually a 512 megabyte attachment space according to the stats and product usage. Now, as I said, the comments and reminders are free. So for example, if I wanted to add a comment and actually tag someone in it, I can do so. And that's helpful for Teams if I wanted to post them there. So that's an additional benefit to the application. The other thing is reminders. Reminders are very basic. You can only set them to say, times and dates. You can't necessarily set them to devices. But at the same time, that is very helpful as some applications don't actually allow you to use reminders or put it behind some form of the paywall, although this is actually embedded inside of the free experience. So this company is a company that's been around since 2003. They've obviously been focusing a lot on the project management software, but are probably looking at the Wunderlist market to try and jump into. They're a German company, and this in the Plus plan, I believe, has some connection to the Zenkit, Gantt, and the Kanban abilities inside of the main app. And I can almost see this as a vehicle for people upgrading to Zenkit, which some companies do as a way to sort of, capture more people early on, get them impressed with the software, and then upgrade them to Zenkit, the bigger application and the main one. So folks, hopefully you enjoyed this review. It's free to download. It actually launches today. And I just want to let you guys aware of that. But again, it is a pretty impressive application for its first launch. I thought this would be more free than it was, but it does have some limitations. But a great Wunderlist replacement if you're looking for almost a visual bicarbonate copy, and also obviously the ability to start sharing lists and getting tucked into what you are used to inside of Wunderlist. So folks, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do like this video if you enjoyed it. It will help more people find it here on YouTube. And also subscribe if you're new. It'd be fantastic to have you here. Anyway, folks, I will talk to you all very soon. Make sure to have a great week.